shit like my 9 to 5. Once I came to that conclusion, like hooping is like my 9 to 5, it was everything changed.
It's a vigilante season, man. I done rolled and became a boss since the last time you met me, man. Okay. Things have changed, man. Niggas running around talking about my lord, nigga, man. I run the organization, man. The streets is mine, man. I make bread and I like niggas follow me, man. I would never work for that cornball ass nigga again. Me? I'm a boss. I'm not with that. It's never nothing no more. Like, I look like a boss, I feel like a boss, I taste like a boss, nigga. Max Big Avail. Fuck out of here, man.
Niggas might as well fucking me anyway.
Any old motherfucker.
I got that fire one. Green, huh?
The way I ride for time, just reflect.
How many outfits do we got?
13 sets.
Okay.
Just like your coldest shit.
Yeah.
And directing how you want them to pose. Like, you know, nothing's in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, just the coldest shit, though. Like, hands, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know, just natural as hell, like, you know, if you dig and he'll come find you, like,
yeah,
the camera gotta come, he'll come find you.
Yeah, okay.
You just gotta be comfortable, right. You know what I mean? If you feel uncomfortable, don't pose like that. Whatever you will be doing, nigga, however you kicking it, me and you just kicking it, your mannerisms, like,
right.
Yeah, my nigga,
right.
Yeah, so just in front of a camera, it's like you talking to 20 of your niggas or you just on the corner, because this shit just exudes. We the coolest niggas. But we not trying too hard.
Yeah.
You know, we naturally like it.
It's more so like we just, how we know they hate you. You know what I'm saying?
What?
You know them niggas hate you in the club with this shit on.
Man.
Let me know if this bitch wrinkled on camera.
I might be fresh off the bird. I might be fresh off the bird. I'm
completely changed the game. They used to do that and I'm doing it. You know, niggas never seen this before. The GOAT started this. Don't forget who pioneered this shit. He made the transition so seamless and beautiful. Don't forget who the Don is.
Oh, I see we gotta put that weed in that nigga mom. That's when that nigga give you all the shit I want.
Don't meet me in the car.
My niggas say his daughter.
Though I can't swear I won't change.
Yeah, buddy. Yeah.
Cocky something that I just can't help. Especially when them 20s are spinning like windmills.
I didn't, I fucked with Max B, like I fucked with him, but I didn't know it was Max B. I just fucked with the nigga who was rapping on this shit, though. But I didn't know it was Max B, though.
The GOAT. The best voice ever.
Marvin Gaye.
Marvin Gaye.
I didn't know, dog.
But I was like,
that nigga cold.
Bazzing my nigga behind the camera, my nigga Al.
Can you put that bitch out there?
Oh. Company, I'm gonna pay everybody here, nigga. And I want y'all to know, you gotta spend your money. Don't be trying to save, don't be scared. Spend it. Spend it. You know what I mean? I'm in Detroit right now. I'm investing in myself, I'm investing in my niggas. I'm investing in my people. If you scared, you never gonna make it. Mm-hmm. If you scared, you can't make it. And if you scared, you don't believe in yourself. If you save money, you don't believe in yourself.
Off with it. For real.
If you being cheap, you don't believe money gonna come back. Get out of that motherfucking consciousness of thinking money is anything but energy. That shit just energy. Stop thinking it's some physical shit that's gonna run out. If you think it's gonna run out, it is. Because you're telling the universe, you don't trust the universe, and you're telling yourself you don't believe in yourself. So I don't save, I don't do none of that shit. I put that shit into my dreams, into my family, into my niggas. Because that's what I believe in, that's what I trust. We can't be half-stepping out here. If we doing it, we doing it. We not playing, we not half-stepping. DCTG is chasing your motherfucking dreams and not stopping till you getting them. If it's roadblocks, fuck it. Run through them. But just don't quit. You do not have to struggle. Live lavish. You do not have to struggle. That shit is fake, man. Struggling is fake. We changing the whole idea. We don't have to hoop, we don't have to rap, we don't have to sing, we don't have to be motherfucking background dancers no more. We creative geniuses. We the new breed, we entrepreneurs. You dig? All my niggas is with me all the time.
Lord.
You know what I mean?
Out here.
Ooh, you see gutter in that shit?
Motherfucking blue, bad motherfucker, ain't it? You know what I'm saying?
DCTG Media, please spell it with the dollar sign. This is my partner, president of DCTG Media, El Presidente, Edward Ramirez. Aren't you at DCTG Media? Our standard is fucking awesome. At DCTG Media, we have our meetings on. Today
your body is a blue
sign here. This car already ran today.
That's all I'm gonna say. Besides this, I'm going to.
more. Don't stop, I've been waiting on you. Baby, don't stop, I've been waiting on you. Baby, don't stop, I've been waiting on you. Baby, don't stop, I've been waiting on you. I can't wait no more. Love, I'm coming home to you. I think you know what's in store.
Bright
This is a band, though. You feel me? This is a band, though.
Feeling Al?
Mm-hmm.
I smacked this shit in the back of this bitch, dog. Yeah. I smacked that nigga shit to the gate. Nigga was young as fuck, though.
I ain't like that shit.
It wasn't no, it wasn't a Northwestern cuz or none of that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah.
I used to. You know, I'm like talking about the past, but you know, I used to make it hard for niggas,
man.
You know, in and out, you know what I mean?
That's what it is, man.
That's how I'm a machine, man.
Real shit, boy. Tough for niggas, man. Why you remain in the G? Until the moment you expire, you know what it is. To make nothing out of something you have in your biz. And don't be crying, and it's something you... This long guy is free. That nigga trying to hurt me. Shit.
Tommy's in this bitch.
Hell yeah. Tommy Hearns showed me my first Bentley. The first time I ever seen a Bentley, like a foreign car, a luxury car, was Tommy Hearns here at Crunk's. Tommy Hearns was that nigga to us, you know what I mean? So he used to come try to hoop, but we used to kick his ass. When he used to try to hoop, we used to kick his ass, so he used to threaten us, like, come to the boxing ring. You know, we like, hell no. But I did used to go down to the boxing ring. Or the gym just to, you know, spar and shit. I used to do that shit. Not spar, but just punching back, do like little boxing workouts. I never got in a ring with a nigga. Way too pretty for that. Yeah. Yeah. It all counts. Everything counts. Damn, I'm good.
I'm good.
Man, I'm good.
Right there.
Yeah.
Shit, what? Gutters?
We good.
Okay.
We done. All right. I want niggas to get a close up on these Gucci rubber duckies.
They ain't gonna break it.
So many, you know, in the world with these, man. You know, we got waves for every bump on your face, nigga.
You know,
we got waves for days.
For every brush you niggas got, man.
Every brush you niggas that stole.
Diane's, man. That's where my Diane's went, man. You niggas have stole my way since 96, man. Dick handling, man.
You stole
it. Man. You gotta be yourself, baby. You got your own skin, baby. You feel me?
Period.
Y'all ain't shit right now, baby. You niggas trying to be me, man. You know what I'm saying to my niggas, man?
Play it, please. I'm the macaroni with the cheese.
Yeah, the rubber
blueprint,
dog. Wrong.
I can say it now. I'm the blueprint. I'm showing niggas to be a franchise. This is franchise, and I'm on site. We don't save. We ain't scared. We're doing everything we want to do. We're free. We're earning our freedom. We're taking our freedom away. We're hustling. I don't even, my lips and shit don't feel like they moving. It's so cold. It's 2 degrees. My lips feel like, I hear words coming out, but my lips feel like they ain't moving like the cartoon. I'm only wearing my shit like Method Man from here on out, dog. You know what I mean? Method Man, if that shit ain't 2X, I don't want that shit. If you try to pass me a large, you know you flat disrespecting me, dog. I'm only wearing my shit like Method Man from here on out. Nah, life is good and generous. Like my nigga Chase and Cash say, Chase is actually in town right now. We about to go check him out at this venue, watch my nigga perform. You know, the joints is rolled. Everything is in abundance. You know, period.
I'm rocking with me, so that's all good. Y'all make some noise, man. I love Detroit. I came all the way from New Orleans, man. Y'all know that's a hot place, man. Yeah. Clown Brothers in the building. That's my brothers, man. They got me guys and motherfuckers. So y'all look, man, look. I need y'all to make some noise for APX, man. Them some guys that believe in themselves, man. They believe in y'all. You know what I mean? I love the fact that we got a room full of us in the room together, man. They said LSU, this nigga crazy. Nah, but nah, man, right now it's all about Detroit, and it's all about New Orleans and Detroit coming together. If any of y'all ever want to come to the city of New Orleans, man, make sure y'all pull up. Let them know, man, y'all met Chase and Cash, and y'all good to go. I swear to God, I mean that. Anybody who ever been down there, I'll let you know what's up, man. So let's get this party started, man.
Turn a 2 into a 4 flat. Niggas out here trying to play games. I ain't never been for that. Skirt skirting like a Kodak. In a brand new throwback. 97 SL Benz with my name on the floor mats. I remember I was broke. Niggas left me out in the cold. Yeah, I was all on my own. So I had to go and get the dough. Met Hit Boy and Polo. Started surf clubs on fold. Now it's crown bearers on the throne. And we never ever going broke. So hard and you know that. Skirt skirting like in Kodak. I remember all the broke days. I ain't ever trying to go back. Know that. I ain't ever trying to go back. I remember all the broke days. I ain't ever trying to go back. Hustle hard and you know that. Skirt skirting
like nigga Chase just performed and shit at Mystic Lounge. Real niggas do real things. Method Man Supreme came to support Chase. I'm also on this bitch as like an executive too, because I got DCTG Media, so I'm scouting sound. You know what I mean? Like, I'm everywhere, nigga, doing everything. You know? My sign. My sign. Don't compare me to these niggas. Man, these niggas ain't hustlers. Niggas is not hustling.
Gotta get some shit on camera, man. We gotta chop in. This is an episode right here. This nigga, I really feel disrespected because I pulled up on my nigga early and he ain't recognized me. And I felt some kind of way because I'm me at the end of the day. We brothers. This is supposed to be a wave god thing where, like, he's supposed to feel my energy. It's supposed to be like Super Saiyans, you know, when a nigga in the radius, you're just supposed to be able to feel a nigga presence. This nigga looked at me crazy. Y'all should have seen the look on this nigga face, bro. He really looked at me like he didn't, like he was getting swarmed by some crazed fan or something. That nigga tried to, that nigga hit me with a cold shoulder in 11 degrees.
Niggas be calling me, you know, I had to make sure.
I'm like, yo! This nigga was like, what up? Like, bro, you
Diana Ross on niggas,
come on,
man.
Bro. Nigga hit me with the cold shoulder at 10 degrees, man. But we brothers, so I ain't tripping.
I ain't know that was my nigga.
All love.
Hey, man, this is Superstar. Look, I want this nigga to start representing Crown Mary.
No, he DCTG know what's up. Media. He bullshitting. He's saying that he know niggas been repping before.
Yeah.
And it's like Rick Ross cemented. This nigga put me on Ross all the way. I was a fan, but he cemented it because the music was there, but he put me on the interview. Yeah. And if it's your dog shit, you gotta rep it like you own it. So anytime you see me, it's DCTG. Whether you see me with him or not.
Yeah.
Y'all done seen us in New York giving opportunity to niggas to rap on camera. Y'all done seen us in LA. Y'all done seen us in Detroit looking like, making it look like it's London. Now you seeing us in the middle of the snow. Niggas still fresh. Gucci down, double RL down, smoking big weed, being very natural. We leaving organic in 2017 because y'all niggas kind of tainted it. My man right here, if y'all pay attention, he really go hard every day. Red Burrow baby bananas for the real ones.
I'm too
the
banana,
melon y'all. Every day.
You know I'm doing
high energy. I see it, I have to step my shit. I'm like, ooh, I was about to go get a veggie dog. My niggas all fruits, so I gotta stay strong, man. Other than that, it's always DCTG. Make sure y'all tune in, go to the website, shout out my nigga Eduardo, the CEO. Y'all check him out, he always retweeting good game. And yeah, man, the media agency is popping. Y'all go to the website, sign up right now. It's no fluky shit, it's all legit, y'all know how we do. Y'all seen Coach Cal put niggas on game. When y'all seen Coach Cal? What? Yeah. First of all, he ain't really got no players on that level doing this type of shit.
That.
So that lets you know how real it is. Coach Cal sent the tweet out. Several tweets. Real tweets. Not these old copy and paste. My nigga came up with his own dialogue in the tweet.
Yeah.
So go sign up. DCTG. No promises, all progress, all profit, all fulfillment. Niggas ain't giving nobody no promises because ain't nobody promise us nothing. But at the end of the day, if you're innovative and you got imagination, you got it inside you, you're about living it on the highest level. You've seen us, man. Y'all seen us go through our times of trying to figure it out to where now we allowing to have a platform to where we could unite. Whether it's mine or his or mine. The whole thing for us is we trying to give opportunity. We not trying, we are giving opportunity. That's why the website is up. That's why it's a media company. We're giving y'all coverage. We're giving y'all another platform to come and have a home. Whether y'all stay with us for 30 years or y'all stay with us for 3 years, at the end of the day, it's about coming find where you can blossom at. And everybody need a place to start. I had that with Polo the Don. He had Zone 4. Salute. We doing the same thing, man. We turning it around, man. Yeah, man. So it's lineage over here, man. What y'all knew us for, that's cool. What you about to get to know us for, that's what's up, man. Real talk.
Gucci boots, talk about those. Here, talk about, let me, I like that bitch for you like the movie.
Vintage, man.
You know what I mean?
Niggas know what's up, man.
It's the 1930s, nigga. You understand?
We the hood.
It's the 1930s,
the
gloves.
The ghetto Peaky Blinders right here, man. Y'all know what's up, man. But yeah, man, Gucci utility
talk
boots,
about
man.
It, man.
Gucci,
talk about
these is like when you see the motherfucking Benz in the army, when you see that little bog, the mod bog. That's what these is, man. Very vintage, man. Y'all need to get these no more. Y'all niggas buying Gucci's with the tigers on them and shit.
Uh-huh.
They don't want no Gucci's with no tigers on the shoes, man. That's for girls, man. That shit for babes, man. Real talk. So, yeah, living life, man.
I'm trying to go back. Hustle hard and you know that. Skirting like I'm Kodak. I remember all the broke days. I ain't ever trying to go back. Know that. I ain't ever trying to go back. I remember all the broke days. I ain't ever trying to go back. Grind. Push it to the limit.
Can't get water. Keeps me energized. Keeps me healthy.
Push it to the limit.
Are you tired of drinking tap water? Are you tired of not knowing exactly what's in the water you're drinking? Are you tired of being insecure about your belly? Don't you want abs like Supreme? Start drinking Kangen water. One sip can turn your whole life around.
I just burn out like on these. I don't really like counting.
I just go until like my shit is like you can no more. Mm-hmm. But then I want to go past that. Now, that's how you like reach your potential. I'm after greatness, baby. Shit. This shit about greatness. This shit about being at peak state. Peak state of mind, peak performance. I'm performing at a high level every motherfucking day, and that's with my body, my mind, my spirit, my businesses. DCTG Sportswear. It's like the highest level, and that shit start with our habits. So being in here is like challenge. I gotta work out every day for the challenge. Challenge, that's what drives me. I love it. Niggas who know me know I'm a vicious beast. I'm just a cool nigga, but everybody who know me know that I'm a vicious beast. I'm gonna attack life, so the way I do that, I challenge myself by working out, and when I feel like there's nothing left, I can't go no more, I gotta do five more. You know what I mean? I gotta do five more. I gotta push myself to my limits every motherfucking day. Being great just might not be for you. This shit not for everybody. Shit will come with pain and heartbreak. Betting on yourself, losing. It's changing the world shit. Niggas thought they knew me, but they didn't. Set. They gonna be here. I'm doing this shit for me. I'm in competition with what I'm capable of. That's it. Nobody else. Chase greatness. We do shit every day. No matter what.
While drinking.
Life is good, man. Life is so good. Life is beautiful. Nigga, free. It's freedom shit, dog. That's what it's all about. Being able to do what the fuck I want to do, whenever I want to do it. You know, whatever comes with that, I'm accepting. Like, I want $1 billion. I want more than $1 billion. Whatever comes with that, I accept. You know what I'm saying? Everything changed. My whole, you know, life changed. Like, I could. Everything changed. Niggas start feeling different, man. Like, I don't know if y'all could have seen it through, you know, the past episodes, but shit started to change. I started becoming supreme. It's, you know, it's serious. It's spiritual. You know, death's rebirth, like CDR did, seriously. It's not just like me talking, like, that is my former self. That is my 3D self. Like, I don't relate to that self anymore. Like, this is a new, like, person. Shit, I'm very grateful for, but it's just my past. You know, it's just something that I used to do. And we got to think about it. Like, I've been doing that shit for 20 years. It's like, I want to be a solo act, man. You do something for 20 years, it's like you can do something else. But that shit was like a restriction. Like, I started becoming bigger than that. Nigga, like, how you bigger than the NBA? It's like, I'm bigger than the NBA, nigga. Period. I'm not one thing. You know what I mean? I don't understand. I'm a life past seven. I done been told by real seasoned, you know, spiritual people, like, you the chosen one. Like, you're a life past seven, and you got an incredible path, but you one of the chosen ones. It's not a game. Like, wave God is spiritual. I'm not whatever niggas thought I was. I'm not nothing, and I'm everything at the same time. So it just started feeling like I couldn't be me in that shit. And plus, you know, after the last situation, it was like clear to me, like, nah, the work, all of the toil and work is just not worth it. If you're not in control of the opportunity. And I started feeling like a boss. That's the thing. Once you start feeling like a boss, you can't ever go back. Hoop niggas ain't hustlers. Like, that's gonna hurt some feelings, but hoop niggas ain't hustlers. And I am. You know what I mean? Like, people may think, like, I'm a hooper first, but I got a mind. Like, I'm different. Like, hooping is what I did, but my mind is my gift. So, when I say hoop niggas ain't hustlers, that's just true. Hoopers gotta work hard as hell just to wait on the opportunity, wait for somebody to call them. Like, all right, you can go here, here, here. It's like you a worker. You feel me? It's like I started becoming a boss. I'm not a worker. So it don't matter how much they pay you. They could pay you 200 mil, but they making more. No matter what they pay you, they still profiting. Crazy. And they make more, and they don't work hard. So, I mean, they don't work as hard. They're not putting their bodies on the line. They're not putting their livelihood on the line. So, I was done with that shit. I ain't never gonna be, like, a victim to somebody else in control of my destiny. Like, that's just not gangster for me. And I started feeling that for years. You gotta look back on my Instagram. Shit started to change. You know what I mean? It was more like lifestyle pics. I was one foot in, one foot out. You know, like, I really had to look at that shit, that hoop shit, like, my meditations, look at that shit, like, look at it as exactly for what it was. That shit was not making me happy, period. It wasn't making me happy. So anything not making me happy, I can't fuck with it, period. But I close my eyes and look over here, and it's like, it's nothing. You know what I mean? It's like, you got the clothes, but you don't have nothing concrete. That's what following your heart is. That's what being fearlessness is. That's what being fearless is. You know, fearlessness ain't you just, fear don't ever come. But it's like, when the fear come, you still be like, fuck that. You know what I'm saying? It's cold. Yeah, yeah, nigga, like, close my eyes, that, you know, I had to really be real with myself. Like, how is this hoop shit making me feel? You know, I'm feeling something inside of me that's like, you know, it's growing. You know, it's like I feel like I'm growing out of my identity. Like, everything I was going through was spiritual. It was never spur of the moment. Like, fuck hooping, I'm done. It was like, nah, this was years. You know, this was years, and it was pushing me into my calling, but I didn't know at the time. You know what I mean? I didn't know that shit was pushing me into my purpose in life. So I started feeling so restricted, like, I can't say this. You know, I'm getting piss tested and shit. Nigga coming to my crib watching me piss. You know, I started feeling like this some slave shit. It's like, damn, just because, I mean, I'm just trying to hoop. Like, what the fuck is this? Like, it just started to make me feel like uncomfortable, flat out. It was like I was growing out of that lifestyle, like traveling, being around, you know, like. And I'm the type of nigga, like, I might just be in a room and the nigga might just be jealous, you know, just because I'm around. My presence is like a threat to motherfuckers. It was like crazy. So I used to go through a lot of shit, you know, with these teams, and it was just starting to become like, yo, this shit black. Like, I'm a don, but I'm a happy. It's like, I don't believe in being unhappy. And it was like, this shit like my 9 to 5. Once I came to that conclusion, like, hooping, it's like my 9 to 5. It was, everything changed. Everything changed. You know, everything changed. I was like, I always been creative, always had ideas, and
I never wanted one stream of income. You know, like, I feel like having one stream of income at any time could paralyze you. If a nigga like, nah, you done, and somebody else in control of it, it's like, oh man, you like the puppet on the stream. If the nigga in control of your income be like, you done, we gonna go with somebody else, your world shake up, you know. And that's how it was with Hoopin. I wanted to expand. I wanted to do other shit. I wanted to hustle, like I wanted to go after the whole world, you know what I mean? Like my role models, the people I look up to, you know, do a lot of shit, you know, leave a legacy. And this ain't no disrespect to any old hoopers, but once you done playing that sport, you done. Like, I know who Mitch Richmond is, like, he was one of the coldest niggas. You know, I know who Michael Finley is. I know who, you know, these older players are, but the truth is they're just not relevant today, you know, and that's no disrespect. I'm saying this with all respect. They're not relevant today, and I don't want to be like that. Like, I don't want to just fizzle out, you know, and in the hoop world, you hoop until you're 35, 36, then it's like you start not looking wavy no more. We see them niggas, they just look like they're a little overweight, you know. Niggas' hairlines is going back. It's like, damn, you used to be wavy. You used to have shoe commercials and all that shit. That just can't be me. It's like I'm playing this shit for the whole, I'm going after the world. And with that, I can live like I can be happy. You know, I wanted to hustle, like I said, again, it's no disrespect. Hoopers ain't hustlers. You got there, you know, taught to wait on the opportunity, not go get it yourself. Taught to just be like, all right, waiting on the phone call forever. You know, your kids at stake, your girl kind of looking at you like, what are we doing there? You know, it's like, nah, so I want it out. I want it out. I want it out, but again, this is important for everybody. Like, I want it out, but it wasn't no perfect time. That's what niggas be waiting on. Like, I need the perfect time. No, you gotta do it now. Again, when I was done with basketball, nothing was concrete. I didn't know I would be a CEO. I didn't know, you know, DCTG Sports would be worldwide. I didn't know I would be partnering with Kagan, the most natural water. But no, I didn't know all of this shit. That's the thing. Once you open up to your purpose, shit just start happening. Shit just start happening for you. So, again, I got to that point where I was looking at hooping. It was like, I'm done with that shit. But I looked over here and it was like, it ain't really nothing concrete. So, you know, that fear came. That fear came. You know what I mean? But it's like, that's what fearlessness is. You feel the fear and then still face it. You know, I tell niggas all the time, if you feel fear, run towards that shit with your eyes open. Run towards it. You know, everything after fear is wavy. Like, after you face your fear, man, whatever it may be, you know, you like unlock, cause you unlock some potential within yourself. So I just follow my heart with this shit. You know what I mean? It's like, I was bigger than this shit. I used to want to be a millionaire. Like, that's thinking so small. That's thinking so small, dog. What's $1 million, man? It's like, we don't even know how limited we are with our beliefs and our dreams. I want to be a millionaire. It's like, niggas got billions. You can still be a millionaire worker. You can still be a millionaire worker, so. I need $12 billion, you know, and I don't give a fuck what you think. I mean, I love you for watching this. I appreciate this. But when I say I want $12 billion, I don't give a fuck what you think about that. I don't care if you think it's attainable or not. I'm infinite. You are too. But the difference is I believe it. Everything is start with belief in self. If you don't believe in yourself, nothing happens after that. The formula is belief in self, then however much belief in self you got or lack of belief in self you have determines the action you take. So then, if you don't believe in self, you might not take any action, period. But say you do, you somebody that don't believe in themselves and then take the action. Action is kind of weak, skeptic. You know, then the result gonna be shit. And then you're gonna be like, see, this shit ain't for me. And you're gonna become more pessimistic and more skeptic. And then that shit is a cycle. The nigga who believe in himself, he always gonna win. Always. You know, the nigga who believe in himself gonna take that confident action. Then he gonna get a good result. And then he gonna be like, I knew I was waiting. I knew I could do that shit. You know, I knew it. And then the cycle continues. The nigga who skeptic and pessimistic, he keep getting broken. You keep losing. This shit about winning more than you lose. You're not gonna win all of them, nigga. I lose. I lose, nigga. You know, I'm not winning them all out here. I'm just so pretty, you know. I know niggas think I'm winning them all. But I'm not winning them all, man. I lose out here, nigga. Shit is heartbreak sometimes. Pain. Heartbreak, nigga, to fight back the tears. You know what I mean? This is that. This is that. But it's like, nigga, don't be a slave. You know, don't be a slave. We want to win more than we lose. Shit, we win 6 out of 10. That's beautiful. Only way 6 out of, only place 6 out of 10, 60% is bad is in school, which is not wavy. School just teach you how to be a worker. And the free throw line. Nigga, when you're shooting free throws. 60% anywhere else, damn good. It's all perspective. Nigga, baseball, you hit the baseball 3 out of 10 times, you're in the Hall of Fame. It's all perspective. Nigga, so scared to fail. You're gonna lose, man. Fuck it. You gotta lose sometimes to learn certain lessons. Just don't be scared. Go after it. At least try, my nigga. At least try. At least shoot your shot. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just shooting my shot at life. You know, and I like the path I'm on right now. See, I'm free. I'm in the pool. It's December. It's 1 degrees outside, nigga. You know, I got the biggest room in here, and it's not because I save money. I don't do that. All my money is always in the street, into my businesses, into my companies. So don't look at me as like a nigga with liquid money. Nah, my shit is always into the street, always in my businesses, always. Hustling until I get a certain fluidity that I need. But nigga, you can't deny it. Y'all watch me because y'all know what time it is. I ain't got to talk about it. Demonstration. Y'all know I'm iconic. Y'all know I'm setting this. You know I'm setting these trends. You know I'm creating the wave. That's why y'all fuck with me. And this is my responsibility to you. Like, yo, let's go. DCTG. This shit long lasting. It ain't just got to do with sports. It's a lifestyle, nigga. Work out. Be your best. Peak state. Focus. You know what I mean? Take life serious. Hustle. Give it your all. Be passionate.
You remain.